In this video, we are going to look at how to create a new dashboard. And I'll be looking at the claims and weather data that's used to predict the total claim information based on insurance coverage type and the vehicle information, as well as the car owner information. So in previous videos, we looked at creating data explorations where you can gain insights from your data, such as driver analysis and more. However, we could not change how the visualizations appear, such as we could not add the text, we could not add any widgets, we could not change the colors, etc. So one of the advantages of the dashboard that they give the visual appeal. We can use dashboards to present our findings. We may add the widgets and etc. And even more, when you add visualizations to the same tab that use the same data source, the visualizations are linked. In other words, I can select a data point in one visualization and the same data point will be selected on all visualizations in the same tab, right? So let's go ahead and create dashboard. I'm going to find my data module in here, right click to open the action menu and select create dashboard. Okay, now I have two options here. I can create the tab dashboard or I can create the infographic. Infographic is a long page where all visualizations appear on the same page. Tabbed dashboard consists of tabs where you may split visualizations based on a specific subtopic that you want, the way you want to present. Like for example, in one tab, I could look at vehicle type, right? And average claim amount. In another tab, I could look at relationship between location and average claim amount, etc. Now, I'm going to use the tab dashboard instead of infographic because, as we're going to look in another video, the tab dashboard can be exported as a storybook. Now, I have an option to choose the template. This one here is the freeform template. In other words, you specify the layout that you want. In here, these are the predefined templates. And the plus side is when you, they get adjusted. The visualization sizes get adjusted based on the screen resolution. And you may sort of snap to grid, right? You may put visualizations to fit the size of each section, okay? So, one thing to keep in mind is that the more visualizations you have on the same tab, the longer the tab could take to load. So I prefer 2x2. And also you may use the different template on each tab. The dashboards tab may have different templates. And if you selected a template and at some point you say no, that's not really the template I want to use. It's possible to change. You may always change. Okay, so let's go ahead and click okay. So what do we see right now in here? You're gonna see, when you look in the left panel, you see the data module that we use to create the dashboard. This data module was used as a source. And if you notice that, all the calculations that you created on all filters that you defined, if any, will be available in this dashboard, as long as you edit them in the data module. Now, what else you've got in here is you may add widgets and you may add visualizations, right? So here is visualizations, and we're gonna look at it in more depth in another video, all right? So, and we're gonna look at how to use pinned visualizations and what pins are. And when you click here, you are back to the list of columns in your data. And similar to the exploration, every column has a different icon. An icon is based on the column data type. And here, area at the top is where you define the filters. You may apply the filter to all tabs, or you may apply the filter to each tab individually. All right. So, and suppose that you're unhappy with the layout that you selected, you go into, if you click on a tab heading, the tab name, you see that you have an option over here to change the template, and you may choose another template. All right, so this was a short presentation on how to create new dashboard. We are going to look in more details in next videos. Have a nice day.